can happen and often have happened. So, a night in a row now wants to counter Bride, now tossed up against a knight yet once again.
Instruction, or what is often your primary with the Thermite in this role, and it's going to turn into a bit of an aggressive frag, but Citizen, he's the man behind the bar, and all he's serving is death.
Definitely so, picks up that first kill. Now, a knight will be two men down. Kiox is just holding off the long angle he has just created. Kiox has taken control of that window as Virtue now takes down Blaz, who was going to go on a little bit of a roam. So G2 will now be falling back just slightly, not giving away anything for free. As angles are being held, Durza is just holding off. Kioxus is being...
A moment of a conversation to hope they don't have to use their reconnect for this, or however it might get boiled down. But G2, it's always tough in this situation to know just how much of a victory that was handed to them.
Yeah.
But lock and key. Look at the body that's coming around the bottom of red, though. The time that they have up here is very limited. They've got to go for the swing. The C4 and the pre-call doesn't quite catch the body, but he's well aware and ready. Concerned about the swing on the opposite side, but it's Durza that locks it off, and Kioxus puts themselves into a very good situation. A handful of seconds left. The pop-up and the pre-fire, they're going for the call. They know that the body's behind the mirror window. The spray comes round. He's put bullets to the side of a man, but he can't quite get the lockdown. A 2v1 post-plant situation. They've stacked themselves with a bit of depth. The pre-fire can't quite connect fully again. Scrapes and scratches aren't what you need, but that is a great take against Durza. The other body of Kioxus has sat pretty
onside, but he
swings against it.
A quad
for Virtue handed to him.
All they had to do is not peek a single thing. Wait for the jump-in sound because there was no rotation.
They're going to have to try and hit their way via Moto. They still don't have the pressure on Blue, and they've lost it even more as Yonker locks off the opener against Blaz. The spray comes through on the connection towards Oil Pit, but they cannot quite connect in the same manner. There it is. The trades come back round against them. Virtue with another leaves just Voy isolated by the main double door entrance. 3 seconds. He shakes his head. He knows the situation. He's in frustrations and a... Smiley's otherwise, I'm going to be running through an active and watched firefight. This is the push that comes up. The Banshee gets dropped. The Yana Gemini comes in on the opposite side. There's a swing, they're concerned, but the man is hopped up on a table, takes the fight. But it's Kioxus that wins out. Finally gets the lock on Virtue, but there's that angle he was concerned about before. For good measure, Hungry says, I've got a vector. That thing is a laser beam.
Definitely so, and now we'll be rotating around. Junker will be able to pick up the kill to Blast. Confirms him with the secret shotgun. Holding off on a very, very tight angle there as Hungry finally put down that final mirror window. It is indeed towards the Jacuzzi wall, even though the own knight is not really pushing from that direction. However, now if someone will be pushing into the strip club, into the gym, I have to say, there's not really anything they can do as Junker is dug in deep out of nowhere, has that shotgun still, and will be trying to go for a bit of a rotate. Knows it could be coming up red, knows it could be coming through the door. He's basically stuck in this situation here, but he'll try and pick up as many players as he possibly can before he gets taken out.
Another moment punished. Kayak with another lockdown. There's the back of Yonker. A bit of revenge for the kill just before, but with a handful of seconds, no diffuser and a spray through against, well, at least an exit almost found. Oh, I say, they just drive their way through. He's been able to isolate the single man, but they've got to try and find a way to get rid of him, and it's Blaz over the shoulder, gets a bit of the cover. The smoke goes down, and they're going to try and do the same with the diffuser. Citizen is going on the rotation round red, but he gets caught out by Voy watching Lounge. Kioxus with the cover, and suddenly Virtue, hey, you remember this situation? Yeah, you just got to do it one more time, please, mate. A post-plant situation. There's a couple more bodies this time round, but he's got to find four yet again. And this is a much better setup and a hold, and it is not broken this time round.
As I said, they managed to overrun cash previously. They managed to do it now. Just run in the door. There's just a single come in here and potentially pick up a kill. No, there's a shield. That means Virtue hasn't been spotted, but the kill comes down onto Hungry. He tries to just run in. The shots are being missed by Yonker, but he will be able to get the kill nonetheless. Blue has been opened up now. Now the pressure will be coming in from Dirt as well. And Knights are going to be trying to outrun G2 yet once again, but this time on the bottom floor.
Here's a grenade that wants to pop around the close corner on the A case, and it's a spray round on the backside, but they can't quite get themselves entirely under control. Hidden behind the third box, they're spraying towards a Valkyrie that didn't know that there was suddenly so much pressure from Unknights that flooded in. A bit of a TK, Blaz. Well, you cut through your man, but you got the kill at the same time. A bit of an unfortunate line. Really severely sort of dampens and hinders the plays that you can do. The creep to the top of the stairs, and this is just going to be a, hey, hey, how you doing? How you doing, Aruni? Hey, you want to You just want to keep going back? Yep, that's nice. You are going to keep getting pinged. Gets behind them.
That is dangerous.
Yeah, that was a very slippy move, and that now puts Hungary in a very dangerous spot.
Luckily, there is, of course, a bit of control from the balcony that allows them to at least go for in. There you go. The gunfight gets initiated. Virtue gets off.
They're looking for the fight on the staircase, but they just slip past. They can't quite get the solidity. Citizen goes down and is finally locked off. But there's Amonti on a door, and they get the diffuser planted. But suddenly, it's just Amonti stuck in the corner, sprays through, low health, and Virtue. He's going to the big opener that they have. There's a lot of time here for Run Knights, and they're going to try and draw some attention and go for the diffuser at the same time, but if they can get the cover here, Virtue is the main man, the play, there's the run out, there is the attempt with an SMG, and that was a very good retake from Run Knights.
It definitely was. The Monty was being bullied a little bit there. There's not much. Lose unnecessary lives with only 35 seconds left. They need to push in now. Citizen tried to go. Got taken out by Blaz. He knew exactly where he was and still loses that gunfight. Blaz, well done. And now GT need to push.
Well, here it comes around the backside of Pipes, but there's one more back in their favor. Sprays over the top of the shield, but in the meantime, Voi around the backside is able to swing round. They have all of these angles, all of this sort of control from this space. G2, they've lost themselves a bit here on the source. 10 seconds left, and Blaz has another one for his trouble. There's at least an exit for Kayak. Tries to find a second with the pistol, but Unknights bring themselves back level. And it's just been a great retaliation. But previously, he was punished quite early on. Now, especially with Kayak off the board and almost the Monty 2. There it is, though. Citizen in a position to strike, drives himself deeper, but cannot win the second against Nora, who's able to have himself solidified. The grenade goes a little too deep there, doesn't quite connect with the body, was working brilliantly, but you look at the health of Durzy, you look at the health of Hungary, and those two are fighting in the gym right now, seeing who can get the scrap over the shoulder of the other. The spray comes through, but it's Kayoxis that's the one that lights up, and Durza's able to swing around the side of the Monty. Yet again, the Montaigne is in a very tricky situation, dropped and sprayed across each other. They knew the danger there to play, but on Knights put themselves in the lead.
And Knights take the lead here against G2, who were...
Player might be the one that they can actually punish, but otherwise it's still this sort of steady carry on. It's still this pressure that they're trying to apply here.
The fear is a potential Nitro a Mute might carry along. This is what stops Hungary from really moving in. However, now the flashbangs will be tossed out. It will force the Mute to go for it. A grenade will come in as well and beautifully picked up by Virtue. And this allows the Monty to move up much earlier than we have had before. 1 minute 40 on that clock left, and we'll be taking control of the full rafters now. CCTV wall has been opened up, but you got to keep in mind there's still two players below that could be coming for a huge big flank. We saw it happen from Blaz previously, went inside of oil pit, now hiding inside of the lounge, and Citizen will be able to pick up yet another kill. There's two players down here below. Citizen goes for the triple, not actually a double, as picks up Blaz as well.
Well, now he's going for the triple, but he knows he doesn't have to overextend. This is G2 playing, I guess, a little bit more of a default push here. They obviously took the control they needed to at first. They didn't try and drive themselves immediately into this, but look at the different levels of success it's had here. They, for the first time, find themselves on the good end of a 4-1, and they make sure that they lock it out. It was a calm and collected G2. It was a G2 doing a push that I
very close up to one another. It's Kayak that tries to sneak in. If he manages to get behind the boxes, he's going to be able to go for the kill here. Citizen from above provides the cover. Voi needs to rotate into blue. The plant could be coming down any second now. There's 15 seconds on that clock. There's two people above the blue hatch. He gets one, but is it enough? Kayak goes down. That's the diffuser dropped as well. There's not much time left. They need to go for these drops, and Hungary will do so with the shield. He needs to be covered, but Junker goes down. Virtue in a very important situation now manages to get one. That is going to be at least giving him an opportunity to go for the plant. Whiffs the second, however, and the shield goes down. It is Geoxys to get that final kill. It is going to be the clutch and the retake here for Unknights, who read perfectly what G2 were doing. Send the aggression up top and make sure
still moving and still putting G2 in these uncomfortable situations. It's Durza with the creep up the back stairs. Citizen, I don't think, is fully aware, but neither is Durza. Goes up the back, and that was a moment that could have gone the other way with the default cam not quite reacting in time. Maybe just drifted side of it. There's a drop and a take, but it's Citizen yet again, keeping a hold, keeping a bit of a mantle. Suddenly everything has fled into the hands of G2. They're going going for the stick and the plant, and as Voight gets locked off of Flawless to put them into OT, but it was far from a smooth run here.
It was definitely just a little bit. Grenades are about to be tossed in. 46 seconds on the clock. They desperately need an entry. Blaz will be able to find Kayak, however, as Hungry tries to challenge back. He's being swarmed over now by two or three people from the side of Unknights, but they also realize it's dangerous to try and challenge that Monty. 30 seconds left on the clock. The time is running out very slowly now, very steadily as well, as Kioxus gets yet another kill. It is going to be up to G2 to try and bring it back, but it seems like Unknights might be in control for this one.
The Diffuser being stuck in dirt is what they have to try and pull themselves into. Virtue gets the drop, but gets dropped. It's Blaz, and sort of Chaos is repositioning themselves to try and get that lock off. Hungry's picked it up. The smoke goes for the cover on Blue. They're hoping the spray comes through, but it's the C4 over the top. Hungry is going to stick it until the end, but quickly picked up by Chaos through the smoke yet again. Unknights, hold on. Keep the claws in for the rest of that hole
to try and find Citizen. Hungry will be spotted out, however, and that's the first gunfight to be taken, but he manages to win it. Blaz will go down. It's the top fragger of Unknights together with Kioxus that will drop to the board first, and that allows G2 to breathe just a little bit more. But it's not over yet. Unknights still have four here.
And with Durza underneath with some grenades, he might try and do something tricky, but I guess there's always that concern. Look at that, though. Caught and hatched and waited and baited and perfectly played.
That brings it back to a 3-on-3, and quickly Axe fills out of the crime scene. We'll be bringing it back towards the actual site. Then block his line of sight, and we'll have to force to use his entire magazine, but only 20 seconds are left.
Yeah, great spray there, but look at them trying to drive that diffuser in against it. Durza has to do some pretty hot foot movement here, but Kayak is that pillion on the backside. Voight gets Virtue, but the time is very thin with the drop over. It's Kayak that keeps their momentum going. Yonka has a bit of a hand in the end, but it was a very shaky one as we go. Yes, at least that's in the pocket above that they are holding on to for everything that they can, because it's kind of expected for this to be a big bout of pressure, and it's kind of expected to try and hold yourself in for as long as possible. Forced further away, the bolt will still sort of pop off, but it's Kayak from the opener that's able to drift it wide. A minute left, and they've been able to get that opening body, but they still have the tough push left. Blaz has relocated his way up to the top of red. He was before, but that's going to hand that territory over to Citizen, who's entering, and it's actually Yonker on the dangle that gets the drop. It's Kayak that gets dropped next, though. Top
the Frostmat. No way he gets out of Frostmat. He needs to be picked up. His exothermic is needed to open
it. It's a C4 and it's an impact that might be able to have the biggest impact so far, with Kayak and Virtue both exceptionally low. The spray is attempted round the cover and the shoulder. The pings are consistent from that drone. The diffuser's dropped again. Almost gets the double on the hop in on the window, but it's the triple round the back for Yonka. Suddenly another blue body falls, but Yonka with a 4K is the drive that finally gets G2 over that line.
It was so close. Unknights almost managed to get away with it. You can feel nothing but heartbreak for them. They've done so much work to try and counter-strat G2 into perfection, and they almost managed to get away with it. But in the end, they managed to get away. The Capitao coming in to clear the garage allowed them to open up, allowed them to move through. Of course, the Frostmet almost clutched out.